You're listening to the Magnetic Boss Podcast, where badass entrepreneurs come together to share authentic conversations. We're ditching the cookie cutter approach to building a business and valuing collaboration over competition. I'm your host, Calandra Martin, boy mom, coffee-obsessed coach, speaker, and leader. I help women radiate their brilliance in the online space and create magnetic brands. We are here to have fun, do work we love, and enjoy the ride. Now let's dive in. Welcome back to the Magnetic Boss Podcast. Today we have Erin-Nicole Porter joining us for a juicy conversation. I'm so excited to share this with you. Erin is a spiritual business and mindset coach, trainer of NLP, breathwork facilitator, and the host of the Energetics of Business podcast. She enjoys coaching women in subconscious mind work, somatic healing through breathwork, and the energetics of business. Welcome, Erin. Thank you so much for joining us on the podcast today.
Yay, thank you so much for having me. I'm super excited to be here.
Yeah, this is going to be such a great conversation. I would love to have you start off by just sharing a little bit about your story, how you became an entrepreneur, and what has happened to get you where you are today.
Sure. So hello, my name is Erin. I am a spiritual business coach and also an NLP trainer. So I actually got started in network marketing back in 2012. So I started off as a Beachbody coach, which I feel like I end up finding a lot of people who have started in that realm, then kind of going into the coaching journey. So I started when I was in grad school, actually building my business. I started off as a health and fitness coach, and then I went into group fitness, personal training, health coaching, started taking clients from there. And then I stayed with my full-time job in student affairs and higher education for about a year before I left and went out on my own. So I was doing some marketing consulting for fitness businesses, for other individuals, always had a passion of working with, I worked with students in distress. I worked with marketing. I worked with a lot of like leadership development and kind of like that deep inner work. So as that, that being my background and my love of helping people, working deeper with the mindset, I then transitioned into more business, into more mindset, into more energy healing along the way. So added in certifications in NLP, hypnosis, breath work, and so many just kind of different modalities. I really love like the art and the craft of coaching. It's really near and dear to my heart. So that has kind of been my journey to now having a multiple six-figure business, which is incredible. I come from Ohio and I live in San Diego now. So it's pretty much the dream come true, being able to help others, scale and grow in their businesses, in their own healing, in their embodiment work, and then also being able to live out my dream and my purpose too.
That's amazing. There's so much I want to unpack from that, but I love that you were also a Beachbody coach. That's where I started in entrepreneurship too. It was kind of like my gateway drug is what I joke about.
Same.
Yeah. And I love the variety of modalities that you use in your business. So you mentioned NLP, and I'd love for you to share for anybody that's not familiar with some of these modalities, specifically NLP, what that stands for, what that is, and how it contributes to being a business owner.
Sure. So NLP is neuro-linguistic programming, and kind of like long part of that short, it's really kind of like a user manual for our unconscious mind. So with NLP, we're able to work with the unconscious or the subconscious mind, whatever you prefer to call it, and the conscious mind to create long-term success. Often when people are doing mindset work or coaching work, we're working with environment or the behaviors of somebody. With NLP, we get to work more so on the identity level. And when you can make changes on an identity-based level for yourself, for your clients, through working with their unconscious mind, through working with the conscious mind, change becomes a lot more easy and effortless. So in NLP, we use a lot of hypnosis. There's a lot of, change again on that more identity, values, purpose-based level. So people can, create ease ease and transformation in whatever area of life that they're looking for. So with that in business, so often I see people effort their way a lot through their business. They're just trying to force and hustle and do and go all day long. But there's limiting beliefs. There's, what people might call a mindset block or something like that that's holding them back. And sometimes so many of our beliefs are so unconscious. Like they're so stored in our mind that we don't even realize that it's a belief that we've held from childhood or generations or past lives. And so even within NLP, we can use another technique called time techniques to go in and release some of that. So what I've seen that happen with people is they've realized things that they didn't even know from, let's say, their mom that was holding them back in their business that they were carrying in their unconscious, carrying in the body. And when they can release that, the change begins to happen. And, the success, the results, the freedom that they desire in their business comes at a more easy and effortless level because they're doing the deep healing work to get them there.
Yeah, that's so incredible. I see so many entrepreneurs, and myself included in the beginning, really trying to like force the growth, force the change. Yeah. You see the shiny objects on social media, and you think that if you have everything perfect and polished on the outside, that it will reflect on the inside. So I love that you use these tools to help people in their businesses. You just started a certification program, the Quantum Ripple Effect. Can you tell us more about what that is and how that sets people up to do this work in the world?
Yeah. So I obviously love NLP. I love energy work. I love attachment and trauma and all of the things that are combined that are like the really deep healing stuff, which kind of makes everybody giggle because it's like the deep work, right? So with the quantum ripple effect, something that I noticed in the field of NLP, it was very masculine, very by the book, very structured based, and it was missing the energetics and the feminine and really getting people into the body and into the felt experience along with the unconscious mind. So really working at it from, a mind and a body and a soul and a spiritual level. And so from the moment that I started getting into my NLP certification, I was like, something seems like it's missing. And I wanted to bring that magic and that potency that I was kind of blending everything together with the techniques themselves and bring more of that, again, feminine flow spin to it and the energetics of it. So it was really born from just seeing a need in something that I wanted to create and wishing that I had that experience in my own certification. So bringing that all together, plus adding in Reiki and other things that I'm passionate about, making sure that the people that go through the certification are trauma-informed, that they know how to work with any forms of trauma and attachment styles. I love working with the 5 personality patterns as well. It helps a lot with inner child healing. So wanted to blend it all together in an immersive experience where people get to go through their own healing. They learn how to facilitate next level results, and they get business strategy that's really aligned to them. Because that's what I truly believe, like, create so much success in business. If we're doing our own healing, if we can facilitate and really help people transform, and we're running our businesses in a way that feels really, really good for us.
Yeah, I think that's so important. And to have that on your tool belt is just incredible, especially infusing the Reiki into that program. Something that you had recently shared on one of your platforms was about the logical levels of change and the power of our subconscious and conscious mind. Can you dive into that and share a really incredible, I think you said it was 99.9996% of our subconscious makes our decisions? Tell us more about that.
Yeah. So that is correct. The 99.9999. Some people will say more like 95%. Anywho, it's a huge amount of our day, of our life that we run on autopilot. We run on our subconscious behaviors, things that just come naturally, things that we don't have to think about. We are processing like 2.6 million bits of information per second. And our conscious mind can only handle about 126 bits. which is crazy. So the rest of that is truly, I know. It's truly our unconscious mind that's operating our entire life. So when we kind of kicked off the conversation and we were talking about making change at an identity level and working with the unconscious mind, if you're not working with your unconscious mind, you're efforting your way a lot to that. Because again, it's 99% versus the 1% of your brain, of your body. So where the logical levels of change come to all of this, if you go to my Instagram, you can pull it up there, but the bottom one's going to say environment and behavior. So the bottom two levels, I should say. So those two are more so when we're working with a lot of like physical changes. So if you're making changes in your environment or you're changing your behavior, let's say if you wanted to wake up and, I mean, I remember doing this back in the Beachbody days of like waking up and wanting to work out really, really early and doing that for about 2 weeks and then, falling off the wagon. And sometimes people can't figure out why they're always stuck in that loop or why they can make a change for a little bit at a time, but maybe not a long period of time. And this is it, because it's environment and it's behavior change. Now, as you start to move up the little pyramid here of potential, of values, of belief, identity, purpose, spirit is above that. When you're getting into your purpose, your values, your vision, your identity, and you're starting to work with those changes, again, that change happens easily and more easily and more effortlessly because you're changing who you are, not what you're doing. Very similar if you think about like the be, do, have model. If we focus on who we're becoming, the things that we're doing and the desires that we're having happen a lot more easily when we're focusing again on who we are. So if you can embody, there's where embodiment work kind of comes into this too. So if you can embody, you know, the type of person that would want to wake up every single day, like what's her purpose for that? What's something bigger outside of, oh, well, I just need to wake up and do this thing because this is what I think that I have to do versus like, what is that going to do for you? And someone who has those qualities, what are they doing? What does that feel like? And then starting to bring that energy into your unconscious mind, starting to take on those habits and behaviors on an identity level, and then watching everything kind of spread and the magic happening from there. It's kind of a long-winded answer, but hopefully that helps.
Yeah, that's a good answer. And I think it is something that we see a lot in the online space, especially with coaches, is the shoulding all over yourself. Like, I should totally do that, I should do that. And trying to force something that isn't in alignment with who we really desire to be. So setting those intentions with your values and knowing what your identity is going to help you show up and reflect the changes or the growth that you want to see, especially in your business. So I love that.
Yeah. And just to add something with that too, like with the shoulding on yourself, you know, it comes also into like our truth too. And we have to a lot of times like repair and reestablish the trust within ourselves, because our unconscious mind, like one of the, what's called like a prime directive and one of the basically purposes of our unconscious mind is to keep us safe. So it wants to prove us basically right or wrong anytime that we're doing something new or we're trying something or we think something should be working. Like, let's say if you're launching and last time you launched, you know, nobody signed up or one person signed up. It's literally like the purpose of your mind is to go, hey, remember that didn't work out last time. Here's all these reasons why you shouldn't do this. Let me pull up all of your old shit, all of your old like wounding and everything to keep you safe, because it's trying to protect you. And it also wants to make you happy. Like, that's what your unconscious mind wants to do. So it wants to pull from anything to prove that to you. So what you want to do within that is go collect evidence from other areas where things have worked out, even if it's in a completely different realm or area of your life, and start to bring that in. So when you said that, that just sparked that in my mind, and something to kind of think about. Literally, our unconscious mind wants to serve us. It wants to protect us. It wants to take orders from us. Like, it has all the stuff that it wants to do. So we have to speak very literal to it.
Yeah, definitely. I think that this is where affirmations and practices like that can be really, really powerful. If you're trying to reprogram your mind to think the way that you want it to, Totally. If we have so many layers to unpack, doing this work is going to help make that shift so much easier, like you said before, instead of efforting.
Yeah.
For entrepreneurs that are maybe in the beginning stages of their business, what would you want them to know? What would be a like core piece of advice from this standpoint in business?
Beginning in their business, let me think here. That's a great question. My first thing that comes to mind is like being with your emotions. I always kind of go a lot to the energetics. And, you know, while we can talk about strategy stuff all day long, I really think, you know, when you're beginning in your business, and this is what I wish I was working through right in the beginning, was connecting into myself, connecting into my truth, and healing a lot of my inner child, and healing a lot of the work, and doing what people refer to a lot as kind of like the growing up work. So things like attachment styles and working with our parts and our protectors and our patterns and everything that we are running. I wish I would have began to do that sort of work and understanding my mind and my body and the somatic experience, the subconscious experience. So, you know, if you're just getting into all of this or you're new into it and you're finding yourself maybe like pushing up against the wall sometimes of what else should I be doing? Trusting and surrendering to like, it is a long game. Like, if you're in it for like that quick reward or that quick fix or whatever it might be, centering into your purpose, centering into your mission, why it is that you're here, trusting in that and then doing the work so you can allow more of that in and receive more of that.
Yeah, I think it's so important to bring up the long game because we see from the outside looking in that entrepreneurship is this easy overnight hit six figures process.
Yeah.
And that's not always the case.
Be great, right?
Snap our fingers and have that six figure business in front of us. That would be awesome. But that's not necessarily the case. And the inner work is going to come up at some point. So doing it in the very beginning of your business is so powerful. And I think you providing this for entrepreneurs is going to really help them with making that shift right from the get-go versus having to maybe backpedal or hit an identity crisis in their business where they're not sure what they're even doing in the online space.
Yeah, totally. And I feel like, we do. We want everything to happen so quickly, and we chase a lot of times success. We chase results. We want the 10K months, the whatever K months, this, that, or the other. And it's like, yeah, cool. Like, you know, the income and everything is great, but like, for what purpose do you want it? And do you really, you know, want it at the, if it's going to cost you like burning yourself out and running yourself in the ground and being disconnected from your body and your family and your loved ones. So it's like, enjoy the process along the way, which I know sounds like the cheesiest and corniest thing. Cause when someone told me that, I was like, okay, I'll enjoy it like later on. But when I could really surrender and be with rather than, again, just kind of doing my way through everything and chasing that next goal, thinking that that was going to, you know, meet some sort of need inside of me. Excuse me. I could really surrender into meeting those needs for myself.
Yeah. I find so often that we try to override. I know in the very beginning of my business, I had an affirmation literally everywhere in my house that was trust in your process, because I was somebody who wanted that instant gratification, instant results, because that's the world that we live in right now. But I love the focus on values, of purpose, on why you're even an entrepreneur in the first place, because it helps you shift into doing the long-term work, doing the inner work and showing up in that way.
Yeah. Yeah. Anytime like with clients or myself that I find myself in kind of running or looping in a circle or not feeling sure of what it is that I should be doing or working through, whatever it might be, I always center back into my purpose, what it is that I'm here to do. Cause we start to make it, a lot of times, like in our launch or in the work that we're doing, a thing that's more about us, and rather, and we get in our heads thinking it's a me thing rather than, okay, you know, how is this going to help my clients? And how, you know, if I don't show up or if I'm not selling or providing a service or sharing my gift, like somebody else is missing out on an opportunity that is could create a huge ripple in their life. And so when we can kind of detach ourselves from, you know, me, and thinking about, again, the ripple, like what it is that we're here to do, then we can watch so much of the magic truly begin to happen.
Really, I love the analogy of the ripple. You can picture like throwing a stone in the water and seeing the ripples expand out. And that's the work that we're doing as entrepreneurs. We're not just doing it because it looks cool, but we have a purpose behind it.
Totally.
I want to wrap up our conversation with a fun little game. So the Magnetic Boss podcast has the word magnetism in it. So when I say the word magnetism, what is the first thing that comes to mind for you?
I love this. This is something that I work with my mentor quite often on, because I think when we think of magnetism, we think of like, oh, look at all these like fancy things and let me be magnetized to what people are doing or certain leaders in the online space because of like the lifestyle that they're living. For me, when I think of magnetism, I think of someone that's doing so much like healing work and that they're so tapped into like their soul, their purpose, that people want to be in their energy, that they want to like connect and feel from their soul. It's very heart-centered rather than, oh, I need to sit with like the girls club or the cool club or this club or that club. But it's like, I feel something in there, in their system, that connects me in, that draws me in. And I know that they've done their work, that they're safe, that I can trust them. And from that space, like, and if you can center yourself into that, like so much begins to come to you.
Oh, I love that answer. The energetic trust building is so, so important and something that I preach a lot about. So to wrap up, I would love for you to share with our listeners, what do you have going on in your business right now? And how can everybody get connected with you, learn more about what you do, and check out the quantum ripple effect?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for that. I have the Quantum Ripple Effect Coaching Certification. So that is, we're just getting started this month with the summer class. So still time to jump in for that. And then I also have a breathwork program. So breathwork is another modality that I teach. I do not certify in it, but I teach people and take them through the experience of healing through their breath. So I'll have a group breathwork program coming out this month too.
Oh, so cool.
Yay.
And where can everybody find you on your website?
Oh yes. Erin-Nicole Coaching.com, pretty much Erin-Nicole Coaching on Instagram, all the places.
Awesome. And we'll link that up in the show notes.
Cool.
Great. Thank you so much for coming on, Erin. This was such a great conversation and I am really excited to see what our listeners do with the subconscious work in their business.
Yay. Thank you so much.